Okay, obviously great to get back in the win column, so to speak. Really proud of our players. I thought they prepared all week. I love their focus. I love their mindset. We had our best week of preparation. I thought we played with energy, and we talked about all week long about returning to the standards and the expectations with passion and energy, the inspiration that it takes to play this game. So I was really proud of them. We need to continue to learn as the season progresses. I thought we played complementary football in all three phases. We had a lot of individuals get playing time today, and they deserve that playing time. They worked so hard throughout the course of the week. So I was really, really happy with that. We started fast, I believe, scoring touchdowns on our first four possessions. I thought really, you know, I talked about winning the week and being 1-0, but I tell you, when we got off those buses for the Vol walk, our fans were outstanding. Just the positive energy and excitement, I thought that uplifted our players. Anytime you get an opportunity to play at home, and then all the fans that stayed for the entire game, that was remarkable. But, you know, I thought Josh got us off to a fast start, Josh Dobbs and then Josh Malone, and we were able to run the football. I thought our offensive line did some good things. So just a complete team win. Same thing defensively. We were able to get, you know, them in third and long, and we knew that it was going to be a game. We talked about it being a game of patience because we anticipated them running the 40-second clock down, and a lot of times you can panic as a football team because you're pressing. And I thought our players handled themselves exceptionally well. So 1-0, and moving on to the next week. So I'll answer any questions y'all may have.
Torrey, then Jimmy, Steve.
Coach, a lot of your reserve players and role players did get to play in the second half, but pretty much the entire half. How important is that for their confidence moving forward in the final three games?
Anytime you can gain live game speed repetitions is critical, but I think you could also see our lack of depth kind of revealed itself in this game as well. And we're very, very banged up and very limited in a number of positions. And that's why I've been so proud of this football team all year long, the resolve, the resiliency with everyone in this football family. But it was great because they earned that playing time. And playing time is very, very sacred. It doesn't matter what part of the game. Anytime you get an opportunity to represent the University of Tennessee, that's very special.
Dobbs was not real sharp last week. In this game, he had more touchdown passes than incompletions. Did you have a quarterback do that?
Well, I just know he had a great week of preparation, and I thought our receivers did a great job of catching advance. I thought the second touchdown pass to Josh Malone in the corner of the end zone by the Peyton Manning locker room, I thought that was one of his best throws he's had all year. He was able to set his feet. I thought our offensive line did a very, very good job of providing the protection that he needed to be able to drop back and set his feet. So again, we always say a quarterback is a byproduct of everyone around him. And I thought everyone around him played very well, and that led to him playing a very, very solid and good football game as well. Again, I'm just proud of the kids and proud of Josh and everyone.
Steve McGarry and John Bryce.
Just regardless of the opponent, how important was it to get off to a fast start, to kind of set the tone for the rest of the season after all the slow starts?
Yeah, Steve, it was critical. And we talked about getting off to a fast start, but especially when we knew they were going to run the clock down. And I have a lot of respect for their football program and understand the growing pains that you go through of building a program. But it was very, very important that we started off fast. And I liked the way we executed, and I thought we threw the ball very, very well, especially the deep ball.
John?
What you said, your best week of preparation, you cited the energy as well. First, I guess, why do you think that was the case? And then secondly, how do you manifest that moving forward?
Well, we need to, and that's why I said we need to continue to learn from these lessons, because we have to be a team that plays with great passion and energy. We have to be a football team that prepares the way we prepared, and it was a mindset with our players. I think our players were disappointed, obviously, as everyone in our football organization, of the outcome and our performance last week. And you know, the great thing about sport is you get an opportunity again to prove yourself. And I think everyone was very, very disappointed. And instead of feeling sorry for themselves, they came in with a mental focus and a mindset to get better and to improve. And I thought our energy was outstanding, but it just didn't start Saturday. John, it started Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday night at the hotel, our team was a little bit different. And then even this morning when we got up and did all our walkthroughs, you know, the energy, you know, across the board from everyone in our football family. And again, we have to be that type of football team. And I thought our players respond. Now, how do we learn from that moving forward next week?
Paul Austin and Mike Griffin.
Fletch, back here. Can you talk about Nigel Warrior and how well he played, and then also Markwell Osborne, just how much they've grown really in the last couple weeks?
Both those two individuals, true freshmen, continue to grow. And I think the repetitions that they gained tonight are invaluable, and we're going to need them. And, you know, Nigel has great closing speed, as you can see. He does a great job of open field tackling. Markwell Osborne is starting to get more and more confidence, and you can see not only from the defensive side of the ball, but also in the terms of special teams game. They're doing a very good job, and they're starting to stand out. And again, nothing beats live game repetitions.
Butch, was that the Brandon Johnson that you guys saw in fall camp before he got injured? And then Marquez Callaway, do you maybe take a look further with what he did at punt return tonight?
We've noticed in practice with Marquez Callaway is he's a natural at catching punts. He just has a knack for it. And so it was great, obviously, that he was able to do that. And we take great, great pride in our return game. And I bet you when we watched the film, there was a lot of individuals that won their one-on-one matchups. But Marquez has a knack for it, and he wants to do it. So, yeah, we'll continue to rep him. And again, he provided a spark for us. And then Brandon Johnson as well. You know, we got injured in camp. That really kind of set back his growth and development. And, you know, a game like this, you hope builds confidence amongst these youngsters, because I thought they played well.
Coach, with being able to play so many guys, I know they say that's always healthy when a lot of guys play. And then on top of it, I guess, Florida going down to Arkansas. Can you just talk about the locker room? When's the last time it felt that healthy to you?
I just said this to the coaches. That's one of the most spirited celebrations we've had in our locker room. And I think that's a byproduct, or that's all relative to the investment of everyone in our football program this week. Again, everyone brought it. We had great energy. We had great spirited practices. I thought we competed throughout the course of the week. Now we need to learn from it and move on. But I can always tell, you know, when you lose a game, you know, how are they? That's a direct reflection of their investment when you win a game too. And there was a lot of excitement and a lot of energy, and that was great to see, because you never take winning for granted. Like I say, half the teams in the country lose this week, and every win is very, very special.
Wes,
what did you see? I mean, you haven't seen film yet, but out of John Kelly and Carlin Fields and me today, and do you know anything new on Alvin? Is everything, is he still supposed to come back pretty soon?
Yeah, we'll know a little bit more on Alvin on Monday. Alvin is supposed to practice. And I know he's very driven. He was even out in pregame warmups today, working out and doing recovery at the training room. So we'll know a little bit about them. But I thought our running backs, you know, John Kelly, Carlin, Jeremy Lewis, I thought they ran the ball hard. I thought they ran behind their pads. We didn't have very many negative yardage football plays, which is critical. You know, the only, probably when in my mind the game is so fresh, but probably the only thing right now that we have to, you know, in terms of disappointment that I would like, is I didn't want to kick a field goal at the end of the half. You know, and I kind of challenged our coaches. There's 4 seconds to go on the clock. Could we get another playoff? And then we had a timeout left. Could we get it on there? So I really didn't want to kick a field goal. And as we continue to get down the stretch with the last 3 games, in situations like that where you have the ball and you have 2 timeouts in your back pocket, for us to beat the teams that are going to be coming on our schedule, we got to come away with 7 points there. We can't come away with 3 points.
We got to finish up with Reed, Patrick, Robin Hubbs. We got a bunch of players.
Yeah, just spinning it forward, like you said, getting back into SEC play, even though, what did you take from tonight that you feel like can be crucial down the stretch? Was it just the spirit and the celebration, or was there actual thing on the field you see that could be byproducts?
Yeah, execution, winning critical downs. Our defense did a great job on 3rd down and 4th down. Winning the field position battle, making explosive plays, being able to run the ball, protect the quarterback, you know, we have to shore some things up in the back end of our defense in terms of throwing the football. Obviously, we're going to be challenged with that the next 3 weeks. But again, just the passion, the energy, the drive to win, the will to win, you know, everyone calling out special teams. You know, the worst, I don't want to say nightmare, but one of the most challenging things as a coach is at the end of the game with substitutions on special teams and all that that goes into the game management when the score is at and you're pulling people. And I thought our players and our coaches, but really our players did a tremendous job of really handling the substitutions.
Butch, to start the game, on the offensive line, you with Coleman at center and Dylan at guard. Was that because of Jack's hand or was that a performance deal?
You know, Jack has been battling that on the cast. And, you know, it's just, again, Jack did a great job tonight. And I'm proud of all the offensive line. I thought they did a good job. But, again, it's just trying to, you know, work our way into a five. And they'll compete again this week. But, again, I'm proud of all those individuals. And they work so hard throughout the course of the week. So I believe in all those individuals.
Could you touch on it a little bit with Mike's question, but earlier this week you stressed there was a lot of football left to be played. You had a tough loss last Saturday, a little drama to start the week, to say the least. Just how much different, you know, have you been in a situation like this where the outlook is flipped in 7 days?
Now, I can tell you this, and everyone asked me and a ton of, you know, people around the country calling me. There was no drama inside our building. And I think you know me by now. I'm going to be brutally honest with you and candid and not keep anything from y'all. Is that our team was very focused. There wasn't anything in our building in terms of distraction or clutter. And that's why I'm proud of our players. They came every day. They worked exceptionally hard. They communicated. So on the outside, it may have seemed, but that was manufactured. I'm telling you, and that's why I'm proud of this football team. Is they were a very driven, very focused football team. And this has been a tough-minded football team. You look at all the injuries that we have suffered this year and all the things that test your fortitude and test your character and your competitive makeup, and these players continue to respond for us. And we're going to be challenged the next 3 weeks. And if you remember, when we started on this journey, I said these last 5 weeks would be much, much, much more difficult than the first 7 weeks. And it's a byproduct of, you know, opponents getting everyone's best shot, injuries, next man up, all that. And, again, it's just a good win for us tonight.
But you mentioned not wanting to kick the field goal at the end of the half. I think everybody saw it pretty animated there. Ted Robbins has been kind of normal, but how stressful has the last week, the last few weeks with the losing for you, how stressful has that been?
None at all. I believe in our players. I believe in our coaches. I believe in our process. But, you know, I was animated there because I wanted to score a touchdown. I didn't want to kick a field goal. And so I thought that was very important that the players kind of feed off my energy and they understand that. And I was trying to actually get the attention of the officials as well. So there's a lot of things from coaches and players. We'll go back and we'll review those final plays. You know, could we, we'll do some time plays with 4 seconds left. Could we have sprinted out or could we have thrown a fade ball and then had some time? All those things that go into that. But I'm extremely competitive and just like everyone on this football team, and I want to win. And I take great pride in the way we play. And I think you all know me by now. I love this place. I love our fans. I love our players. I love the University of Tennessee. And I felt with every loss, I am responsible for the losses. And when we lose, I take it personally because I feel I let everyone down in the state of Tennessee. And so I put more stress and more pressure on myself than anyone could ever write, anyone could ever speculate, because the number one thing I don't want to let down is our players, our institution, the state of Tennessee, and our fan base. And I take great pride in being the head football coach here. And I know how special this football program is to a lot of people. And I think we also need to celebrate the small victories. If you look at how you continue to motivate players, how you motivate youngsters, you got to celebrate the small victories. It's like if you're going to lose 30 pounds, when you lose 10, celebrate it. When you lose another 10, celebrate it. I listened to Joel Osteen about that. Celebrate the small victories. So, you know what, we're bowl eligible. First time since 2002 that it's that it's three consecutive years. You know what? That's something to be very proud of. These players in this program has come a long way. I believe we're 6-3 right now. We haven't been in this spot since 2007. You know, let's celebrate the small victories, but also keep the drive and the hunger for more. Are we satisfied with that? Is that the expectations here? No. The expectations far exceed that. But also, let's celebrate the real small victories, and that's how you constantly build success and keep the morale of everyone. It's just like owning a company. You set sales marks. You make it, you celebrate it. You move on, this is the next mark, the next mark, the next mark. And that's why I'm really proud of our players, and I'm proud of the way our fans showed up for the Vol Walk. You don't have no idea when we got off those buses. And the way the fans met our team with the positive energy, that was invigorating.
Thank you, Coach.
Is that Cortez McDowell here?
For Josh or Josh? Jimmy?
Josh, would you talk about your night tonight? 13, only one incompletion, three touchdown passes.
Should have been zero incompletions, but it was just efficient. That was my mindset coming into the game. That was my mindset for the entire offense, just to come out, play an efficient game. You know, if the throw is there to be made, make the throw. If play's there to be made, just simply make the play. Have an efficient day and play with energy and enjoy what you're doing.
Falling back. Josh, I know not all the young guys were in when you were in, but Brandon Johnson was in at a point too. What did you see from Brandon Johnson and even Marquez Callaway once he was able to get into the punt return game?
Just execution, you know, the level of play didn't drop off. They were excited to get out, make plays, and, you know, I had 100% trust in them that they were going to come out and make plays. So, you know, it was really exciting to, you know, see guys like Malone and Juwan catch touchdowns, and then see Brandon Johnson, Marquez Callaway, and different guys just enjoy themselves. You know, Carlin got in the end zone for his first touchdown. Marquez had his first punt return. So, it was a lot of fun to see those guys do well and have success tonight.
Steve, Rob, and Wes, for Joshua or Josh, just regardless of the opponent, how important was it for y'all to kind of get off to a fast start and this pattern of slow first quarters and that type of thing?
Yeah, I mean, it's something that we've harped on all season. So, you know, it's good to come out, play fast to begin the game, and then, you know, sustain that throughout the first half and throughout the entire game, really. I mean, we talked about, you know, one playing an efficient game, but come out and just enjoy playing football. Play for one another, love one another, and you do that and play with high energy, then we'll play well, and that's what we did today.
Corey, in light of, you know, Arkansas winning today, kind of guys getting past this week, how much different was the locker room tonight than last Saturday? Can you just kind of compare the feeling?
I mean, it was just a lot of energy, I felt like, before the game, and I felt like Deuce was ready to go. Deuce was locked in, and everybody was focused on doing their job.
Wes, Jonathan, Mike.
For Josh, I think a lot of people would wonder, I mean, Coach Jones came out and said that y'all didn't have any, you know, drama or anything in the locker room earlier this week. And given the news, I think a lot of people would wonder how there wasn't any, you know, drama. But how were y'all able to kind of keep focused and just do your job and not worry about obviously losing a key guy?
I mean, we're a mature football team, and at the end of the day, we want to focus on the people that are here. You know, since my time here, we've been through a ton of adversity. A ton would be an understatement to say the amount of adversity we've been through. So losing one guy during a week, you know, that's not the hugest thing to throw off this team. You know, we're a mentally tough team. We're focused on our task at hand. We know we need each and every person on this team to be successful, and those guys came ready to play today, and we were able to have a productive day.
Josh, just going off of Steve's question, how important was it to, you know, you scored four touchdowns on your first four possessions to give you guys an opportunity to go out of the game and rest and get the reserves in and get them a chance to play?
It was just an efficient game. You know, that was our mindset coming in. Just make the plays that are there, have an efficient game, and make it as simple as possible, and that's what we did.
Mike, I guess just for both Josh, the 43-yard touchdown, can you guys talk about that play, just the throw, the catch, if you can go through it again?
Well, it was like a three-verb play, and so I was just running around to win and just trusting Dodge to put up a good ball, and he put up a good ball and just made a play, and that's all she wrote.
Yeah, kind of on that note, just getting, I know you guys had like fits and spurts, but how just to get that passing game working, such deep balls again, you guys had some in the beginning and it kind of had a lull, just to get those connections working and hitting on some quick strike TDs, both of you, if you can answer it.
Well, just make the plays that are there. You know, they were playing advantageous coverage for us and we're able to take advantage of that. So, it just went into, you know, our mindset coming in, playing efficient game and being 1-0 this week.
Yeah, it's just about executing and just taking advantage of the opportunities. That's really all it comes down to, and just executing on offense as a whole.
How gratifying was it to have a 100-yard receiving game and 2 touchdowns?
It was great because I finally broke the 100-yard mark this whole entire season, even though I kept coming close. Like, it was just so frustrating when I see games where I had, like, 94 yards, and I just be like...
More catch.
Yeah. So, it was a great feeling to finally just break 100 for the year.
Austin West, Mike.
Josh Dobbs, I know you're not a guy to really dwell in the past or get shaken by anything, but how important was it for you to come out and have a clean game? Obviously, only one completion, a couple touchdowns after, obviously, a couple tough weeks.
Yeah, I mean, I want to play a clean game every week, so... it was good to come out and do that. You know, I'll just go back and reevaluate that incompletion for like I could put a ball on him. But, you know, that's just how I am. I'm always tough on myself. And, you know, I'm just looking for ways to improve at the end of the day. So I'm going to go back, watch the film, see how we can improve and get ready for next week.
For Corey, you know, 7 days ago, you know, there were people were talking about how did this team kind of waste this opportunity. And now, you know, Florida goes down there, Arkansas loses, y'all have a good game today. It looks like things are changing again. Does it show the value of just kind of sticking with it and how you don't know?
Yeah, definitely, man. I mean, perseverance is a trait that we've always had on defense, you know, from the offseason, going into camp, going into this season with all the injuries and stuff. So people talk, I mean, we don't listen. We just work. We come to work every day. We got some dogs on the field, and we just play ball.
So you thought the whole week the team would kind of come out and be focused like this?
No, I knew.
Mike, I'll follow up with Corey on that. I know team goals, I guess they always start out with winning the East. I mean, how quick did you get that Florida-Arkansas score, and does it bring some line? I mean, obviously next week's matchup has certainly got some riding on it with you guys that close to winning the East again.
I mean, in this league, obviously you can lose to anybody, so that happening, you know, really set our sights on. We need to make sure we're playing our best football week in and week out, and it definitely I mean, everybody knows what needs to happen, so we just need to go out there and do it.
When did you see the score?
How quick did you see that? Did you see the final score before the end of the game today?
Definitely. I was looking at the screen.
Anybody else? All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys. Is that it up front, Steve?
start today?
Well, it felt great. I've honestly been preparing myself to be a starter since I got here. So once I was able to go out there and actually start the game, it just really felt good to go out there with those guys and pretty much start it off.
And on the second carry, you know, took it to the house. How did that feel?
Oh, it felt good. It was a perfectly executed play. The guys up front really took care of everybody. And I was just able to see the small seam, trust the play, and just ran as fast as I can. I know the coaches, they want us to trust every play that they call, so I just trusted it and hit it.
Weston, Jimmy? Now, I know your guys always had confidence in what you could do, but how important was it for you and for Carlin and for Jeremy to come out today? And I know Alvin comes back pretty soon probably, but, you know, Jalen's obviously not. How important was it for y'all to get out there and show what you could do today?
Oh, yeah, well, we trust every guy that's in that room because everybody's been handpicked by the coaches to be here. And I'm pretty sure they're confident in every player that we got in the running back room. And for those young guys to be able to come out there and show what they can do, it was really a good thing.
Did you really prepare the same way today? I mean, you know, you say like you always prepare like you're going to start, but when you know you're going to start, any more juices flowing or anything like that?
I mean, yeah, as far as hyping up, bringing up the energy of everybody around me, but I've always prepared the same exact way. It's always going to be a high energy preparation going into every game.
Brett Kendrick called you crazy. Is that a pretty good description of the way you run it?
I mean, I can say that. I'm just trying not to go down. So anything I can do to not go down, I'm definitely going to go ahead and do it.
Do you think you run angry?
Definitely. I would say so.
Obviously, you've been a guy who, you know, you're taking a pounding every day in practice and everything, but a guy who's not had a ton of carries in games this year. Do you feel like being fresh is helping you out a little bit now? A lot of these guys on defense have been playing a lot of snaps all year.
Yeah, I would say at practice, I'm definitely trying to deliver the blow. I don't think I'm really out there getting pounded, but yeah, it really helps being fresh. Those game reps is really precious, so I just try to take advantage of all of the game reps that I can get.
John, Mike, Jimmy, Ryan.
Hey, John, when you busted that long run, it seemed like everybody was hustling down there to celebrate with you. Why do you think that is? Why do you think you have that bond already with your teammates like that?
Well, my brothers know that I'm playing for them every single time I touch the ball. And basically, I was waiting for everybody to get down there. I actually picked up Jayshon at the end of the run to let him know that he scored that touchdown with me. So it was pretty good for us to get out there.
Mike.
John, coming out of Oak Park, a lot of people looked at you as a DB. Like I said, I know Michigan State recruited you hard for that position. How big were you coming out of high school, and how have you been able to build yourself up? You look a little thicker than the last time I saw you in high school.
Well, coming out of high school, I was probably like 200 pounds, soaking wet. So, I mean, I've definitely been able to use this weight room and the weight program that we got here at Tennessee to enhance my body. So it's really molded me into an SEC running back being here.
Can I ask some of your teammates this as far as scoreboard watching? I know you're focused on this game, but Florida's game with Arkansas, some of them said they saw the score of that game on the Jumbotron. Did you catch the end of the score of that game before you came off the field?
I really wasn't focused on it too much.
What is Florida losing do for you guys? Is it a boost knowing that window's still there to win the East?
I mean, I just know that we're trying to be 1-0 every single week, so we're just trying to win every game from here on out.
Would you also talk about the durability that you feel like? I mean, can you carry it 20 or 25 times in a game if necessary?
I can carry the ball as many times as the coaches need me to. That's really, I'm really out there to try to do anything I can to win.
What's the most carries you had in high school?
About 27.
John, what's a game like this do for you guys' confidence as an offense? You've had a lot of slow starts this season. You came out and scored a lot of points pretty fast today. You know, how much does that help, you know, get you guys more confident?
Oh, it's definitely a confidence booster. I'm just glad that we were able to go out there and execute. And that's what we've been preaching all week. We've been preaching execution. And tonight we actually went out there and did it.
John, Carlin said that he took the fumble, you know, with the handoff last week. It's like he said he took that tough, and he had a lot of support around him. What did you guys try to say to him to kind of keep his spirits up after that sort of freshman moment?
Oh, this is going to be a long year. That's all we was telling him. I mean, you make mistakes being a freshman and everything, but we're not going to hang our head on that one mistake. So we got confidence in him, and he was able to go back out there and pretty much make up for it. So today was a good day for Carlin.
Any questions for Johnson? How much, regardless of who the opponent was, how much of this was a game y'all needed to get right and get feeling better?
Well, we need every single win that we can get. So this was a huge win for us, and I'm proud that my guys were able to go out there and get it done.
Coach Jones talked about the locker room scene being a pretty big celebration. You know, can you kind of explain that and what went into that? Why do you think it was that type of scene?
Because this has been a long time coming. We needed this win. We haven't won in a while, and we just, once we got to that locker room, we was able to turn up and just enjoy each other's company.
Anybody else for John? All right, thanks, John.